had an interview with an engineer on the ship, Mr. Erwin Kljakovic Gašpić, who lives in Bartolovec, small village near school. He sailed all over the world.
How did you end up working on a ship?
Well, my uncle was working on the ship, so every few months when he was coming home, he was bringing me a nice present. So I realized, probably it's nice, you can buy some stuff for you. And then, when I started to go to high school, I ended up as an engineer. And after the school, I was trying to work at home, but I lost the job. 1 year I was unemployed. And then I decided to go on the ship. And slowly, slowly, started doing that for the last 16 years.
Were you born on the coast?
Yeah, I was born in Split.
When did you realize that this is the profession you want to do?
Yeah, after maybe 6 months on the ship, and I did the first contract. I realized that I like engineering, like to be on the ship, and it's very close to sleep on the ship, so it's very nice. You can see the world around it.
Have you ever regretted choosing that profession?
Honestly, once. When my older son was born and I was on the ship, so that's the only time.
Can you describe shortly how does your work day look like?
Sure. You wake up around 7, have normal breakfast. If you are eating the breakfast, 8 o'clock you start. You meet in the engine room with the other engine personnel, so you talk about things, what you are going to do that day, and then around 8:30 you take your tools and you go to do whatever is necessary during that day, on the pipes, pumps, engines, and you work around 12 o'clock, then you have a lunch break until 1 o'clock. So 1 o'clock you are coming back again, and you work until 6 o'clock, you continue, or if something happened, you go on the other job. So 5 o'clock you have a break until 6 for dinner time, and 6 o'clock you are back in the engine room until 8 o'clock. So 10 o'clock if you are on duty, and you are duty every third day, then around 10 o'clock you need to go again to the engine room to make a round to check all the equipment.
This is something that can take your life away in the moment when you're on the ship. Are you afraid of it?
Actually, no, because I work on the steamship. We have big pressure on the steam, 60 bars, so anything goes wrong, anything blows up, you won't even feel. But yeah, I'm afraid for my family what will happen if not my life, I get injured, so then I lose the job, and that's a bigger problem than lose your life.
Have you ever experienced some funny situation that you would like to share with us?
Yeah, funny situations. Yeah, we had a lot of them, but honestly, to describe them.
And what about
tragical situations? Yeah, we have a tragic situation where we have a collision, and I was working on a cruise line in New Orleans. We had a collision with a barge, and one Filipino crew member lost a life. And that was really a bad thing.
Can you name some sea you have sailed across?
All of them.
On journeys you've made so far, you must have missed family. Would you change your profession because of that?
Honestly, no. I like my profession. Anyway, now I'm 6 months at home, and when I'm home, I'm doing honestly. I'm just with my family, so when I divide, if I work at home and work on the ship, so I think this is better.
In the end, would you like your sons to follow your footsteps?
Honestly, no. I would like them to at least find a nice job at home, and the situation in the country gets better, so they can live with their wages and Croatia. But if the situation is not going better, yeah, if they choose to go, I will support them. But I prefer not for them not to go on the ship.
Thank you.
Thank you.